Hello, this is Angela Anderson. Thanks for joining me for this acrylic painting tutorial. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to paint a crate of flowers. We're going to do this very simple style and make it easy for beginners. Got my husband Mark with me.
Hey there, everybody.
He's man in chat for tonight's show, so if you've got questions while I'm painting, you can ask those and I'll try to answer them. Let's get started. Alrighty, so I'm using a 9x12-inch canvas panel. This is a Belgian linen panel from Fredericks. Their Pro Series. Love these canvases. They're our canvas sponsor, and so thank you to them for providing this. I have just coated this with a very light coat of yellow oxide. I added a little bit of glazing medium and some water, sprayed down the canvas, and just smoothed it on with a paper towel. So it's kind of thin, just for our undercoat. Our brushes. Tonight, I'm going to be using the Aspen brushes. They're a little bit thicker, more textured, so it'll give us a little bit more of that impressionist style, I think, that we're going for. So I'm going to be using the number 12 bright for some of the larger areas, blocking those in. And then I've got a, let me see, I've got them all mixed up here. A number 8-6, I think I have the 4 somewhere here too, maybe. No, maybe not. Yeah, 4 and 2 brights there. So the brights and the flats are just different from each other. And this one is the 8 flat, and this is, so the flat one's got longer bristles than the bright. I find that bright brush is just a little bit easier to control when you're doing things. I'm not sure which of these I'm going to need, so I just grabbed kind of all the different sizes that I had. So just use whatever you've got that's similar sizes. You don't have to have all these different ones. This is the 6 angle and the number 2 and number 2 ought round and number 4 round, number 4 short filbert and number 6 filbert. So I like filberts for doing flowers, so we'll probably pull those out to do the flowers, possibly this larger round as well. Probably not going to need the smaller rounds, but I wasn't sure for some of the nail holes and things that we might want them. So anyhow, we'll see. Like I said, just grabbed kind of whatever I could find that I thought I might be useful, and we'll find out if we use it or not. Haven't painted this ahead of time. As always, I'm kind of going to figure it out as I go along with you. All right, let's go over our colors. I've got carbon black, burnt umber, burnt sienna, yellow oxide, cadmium yellow medium, phthalo green yellow shade, cobalt teal, phthalo green blue shade, ultramarine blue, doxazine purple, quinacridone magenta, and cadmium red medium. Unbleached titanium, titanium white, and this is my glazing medium that I use just to kind of thin out my paints, make them easier to work with. Let me see.
Do you use that on me?
Easier to work with. Do you need to be thinned out too?
Maybe. For sure. Yes.
If it worked, I'd have been using it on myself a long time. Okay. Moving on. What?
It's a box.
It's a box, yes. Okay. So to draw this, it's going to fit in the... So if you split this one down the middle, right this way, right, and then split it again, this side is going right off the corner or right to the edge of the canvas right here. And then you split it again right here, and that's where this side is going up here. And really just depending on how steep you want this angle, it's kind of, it's almost, let me see, I was going to say it's almost on the quarter, but it's not quite. It's sort of like in between the third. Maybe it is kind of right on the third. Yeah, it's kind of right on the third right here, this back corner. So then you just kind of meet up this with this, you know, however steep you want this. But it turns out that it's about, it's splitting this almost in two. There's a little bit more room here than here. So I might bring it up just a little bit more, but somewhere in there. I've got a lot of chalk on there, right? I'm just going to take the cloth and kind of wipe that off. OK. Okay, so there's our side edge of the box, and of course this angle and this one, these both should be vertical right here and here, and then this line and this line should match up, so somewhere in there like that. Then the line in the middle for the split is also going to, so just think of three parallel lines here, and that will get you your side of your box. I'm sure you've done this before in high school or sometime when they taught you to draw a box. Maybe they didn't ever teach you that. I don't know, but it's been one of those things that it seems like everybody learns at some point. Okay, so then this side is a little bit at an angle. So it comes from here and it goes up just slightly, and it pretty much ends right at the halfway mark here. So kind of find that spot and just kind of do your line across. And then again, this line and this line are parallel. It's going to be a straight line down. It doesn't really matter how wide you make this. So you can make it, you know, out to here if you wanted to, wherever you want to do. This line here is actually slightly off from square. So let me see. Yeah, it's just a kind of angle of the view, I guess. I don't know why that's doing that, but go with it. So kind of like that. And then again, parallel to here, it comes up just a little bit off the bottom by maybe a finger's width, maybe an inch, something like that. And it said, so the top corner is about halfway and it's in by about 3 inches, maybe. Let me see, what was I going to say? Oh, yeah. So on this here, we've got our thirds here and here on our canvas. So this corner is on this side of the third. This corner is right on that quarter mark. So if you split it in half, you look at that quarter mark right there. So this one is right about there. And then again, we're going to find where this comes down, this line here, wherever we made that line. We're going to bring it over here. And then we're just going to open up a hole here and do another line right here. And this, these two lines are not as wide as the one here. So, and then just try to make sure that these two, this board and this board, are about the same size right there. Okay. So there's our crate. We're going to have a little square in the middle that's going to follow the angles of this and this. And same thing here. Follow the angles on the outside, whatever those are. And we're seeing it in the middle under between the boards there, there and there. And then the whole top area here is all of these tulips. So we're just having flower, 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 flower all in here. So I'm not going to draw those in, you know, because we're going to be painting over this whole background. So this is all we need to draw for now. Pretty easy. So welcome. Hey, guys. Glad you're joining us tonight.
Yeah.
I didn't say hi yet, but
we're just going.
Yep.
So real quick, that's a yellow oxide background?
Yes, yellow oxide. Mm-hmm. With thinned out with a little bit of glazing medium and some water. So it's kind of a thin layer. This is, you know, like right in here, as if you put it on solid, you know, right up in here. So it's just you're seeing the undercoat of the canvas a little bit.
You just wiped it on with a paper towel.
Right. Yep.
Wipe on, wipe off.
Wipe on. Yep. All right. So I'm going to grab the cobalt teal here, maybe a little bit of the phthalo green and the phthalo or the phthalo blue. And I'm going to grab some burnt sienna that will make it kind of teal. The more sienna we use, the more muted the color is going to be. So that's probably where I want it right there. Add a little bit more of the blue, I'm just going to fill in. Oh, that's a pretty color. Okay, so I'm going to fill this in, and then every now and then I'm just going to grab some of that cobalt teal and dab it on, and I'm really going to just, this has actually been photoshopped by moi, myself, so it is not the, or what it looked like in the original photograph, but I wanted it a little bit more stylistic since it's just helpful to have a photograph to go with that's got a little bit more interest going on. So about from here down somewhere in here. So if I was something like that.
Somebody asked a silly question earlier.
What was that?
They asked if you ever used a ruler.
I do use ruler sometimes. What are you looking at?
Sometimes, true.
I do. And if you wanted to use a ruler when you do the edges, that could help you get it just right, you know. What?
So before the show started, and when she was doing the just a quick sketch out of it, I look over and it looked like she was doing the robot.
Because I was holding up my, hands.
You had your hands turned.
I was holding up my hands.
And then holding them up to the picture.
That's true.
And down.
It was. It's funny. I didn't really think about what it's going to look like to you. Yeah. I'm sure that was quite entertaining. All right. I'm going to get some purple and brown, blue here. And I'm just going to fill in this area up here. We're not going to see any of this. Of course, this is all the flowers and stuff. So I'll just go ahead and started with that. And then I'm going to add this blue purple to it to fill in the rest of this crate up here.
And did you say you're muting the colors?
I did with the turquoise color. Yes, a little bit. I muted it a little bit.
And what's the benefit of that?
It looks a little bit more realistic when you paint straight out of the tube. It just, a lot of times it looks kind of artificial. Ginger Cook calls them circus colors, which I think that's an accurate, you know, description. I very rarely will I just pull a color straight from the tube, because these colors are not mixed color. Well, this one is a mixed color, so you can see that it's a little bit more like a finished color that you might, you know, see. But all of these other ones are just primaries, kind of almost in their most intense form. They're not really mixed to be like a designer color, you know, that you would use in your home or something like that. They're just primaries. So They look a little childish if you just use them straight from the tube.
Okay. And then somebody else, can they...
Depending on what it is, but yeah.
Can they substitute teal for the cobalt?
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
For sure.
For sure. Totally.
Totally. I miss the 80s.
I watched Clueless first time in forever the other day. It was so fun. That it was from, I think it was from the 90s, but it was just it was a walk. Blast from the past, man. That was interesting.
At least we were cool.
Oh, yeah. So cool.
With my knee-high tube socks and shorty shorts.
Yeah, I got you over that real quick.
And the denim cut off.
Yeah, Europe was not a dresser. Did not marry him for his...
yeah, but I caught your eye with that style, so just stop it. You had this dark side of you that liked men in cut-off denim shorts and knee-high tube socks.
I knew that I wanted that in my life until I met you.
You were so used to seeing guys, you know, with normal pants and shirts.
Right,
and
right. Yeah, I was like, why would you do that? Why would you? Okay. So you took your jeans, perfectly good jeans, and just cut them off.
Well, no.
They were too tight, too. You forget to say that. You probably grew out of them is what happened. They were probably too short.
Exactly.
So they're super tight, and very, very, and you didn't just cut them, you cut them short, like they were very shorty short.
Hey, we got,
they were like Daisy Dukes.
Be careful. We got, you know, we don't want, we just want to keep people focused on
your painting. Get anybody any ideas about that? Do not do it.
We're not responsible.
Okay, so I've got this color down, and now I've mixed up some of this cobalt teal here, and I'm just using the corner of my brush here to kind of brush through, and I'm not going to do as much in the upper area there. I'm going to let it kind of fade out, so I'm going to do the brighter stuff down here, draw the eye forward, and really literally just dabbing this on. It's in the photograph, it's AstroTurf, so now you see why I changed the photo. I was like, really? It's like green AstroTurf, so. Yeah, so. And we may do a second coat on here, but just kind of doing like that. All right, so I'm just going to use what's on my brush here and grab the burnt or the unbleached titanium and some burnt umber and make kind of a gray beige-y color. And we'll use that in our background up here. And you can see it's that color in there is. Using the edge of the brush can help you get a straight line with a, instead of doing it this way, it's easier to get a straight line if you hold it up on its end and pull. Not sure why, but it just kind of gives you a head start. It gives you a more solid line. And I'm deliberately letting some of that yellow from the undercoat show through. So like she's being a little messy, I'm kind of doing it on purpose. So just the style. A little bit messier, a little bit softer, looser. I think it'll look good with this, these flowers. Plus it's faster. What?
Well, we're about done. This is great.
And some white hair on this side, yeah, a little bit brighter. And I'm not really worried about this back part of the vase because none of it's really showing. The flowers are kind of cutting off that whole section there, so I really don't know where that box is ending. It's probably not quite right, but I'm not worried about it. We'll fix it when we paint over it. Okay, so I'm going to leave all these interesting kind of colors and things happening back here that are coming off my brush, too. And that just comes from not over-mixing. So over here on my palette, when I'm picking up new colors, I'm just kind of brushing through a couple of times and leaving kind of streaks through when I introduce a new color. And then that way, when I put it on my canvas, it's going to have a bit of streaking. I think that's pretty good. Go ahead and get some of the lighter color back here too. There we go. All right, I'm going to grab some of the cobalt teal. And it's still sort of wet. I'm going to just add some little dabs in here. You can see this brush has got a lot of texture, so it leaves kind of some interesting texture when we do these brush strokes, it leaves these kind of open, I don't know what I'm saying, texture. I don't know. Can't use my words tonight.
These spots here.
Right. Yes. Okay. Let's work on our wood on our board. So I'm going to grab the size 8, which is kind of small enough to kind of fit in there. Oh, I'm seeing too that I should have brought this in a little bit right here. This section right here where this board is split, it's actually got the green comes in right there. The blue, I should say.
Good catch.
Yeah. Okay, then I'm going to grab that purple and ultramarine blue that was up here. I'm going to put it down here. I think I lost my corner here. I'm not really sure what this corner is here in this box. I'm just going to bring this whole thing over. And this too. And then when I do the corner, I'll fix that box right there. Same deal here. It goes. Okay, so this is going to be one of those things you just have to trust that it's right, because when you're doing this, especially like right in here, the tendency is to think you're doing it wrong. So as long as you got your drawing right, just kind of trust it. Take your time on your drawing on this and make sure you got those angles right, and then
do the robot.
Yep, check and recheck. do the right thing. This is me checking my angles. I'm voguing. That's pretty much what Mark was saying I was doing earlier.
And I should have been playing that song while you were doing that. That would have been perfect.
All right, so mixing up my browns here. I have a little bit of the lighter color in there, that white that I picked up, but I'm just going to do my slats. Go ahead and go over most of that yellow. And the very top of it, I'm going to leave just a little bit of that yellow showing, because that top portion has a little bit of the highlight. That'll help me see where that is too. And while I'm doing this, I'm going to run it in the direction of the boards so that any streaks that we leave will look like they're going in the right direction. So streak it on in the direction that the boards grain, the wood grain, is showing. And this side is actually very blue, so I'm going to get the ultramarine blue and do this side a kind of blue. A little bit of white so that that blue would show up. It was just kind of disappearing. So these darker colors here. I have to say these brushes are a little bit tricky to use for detail work, but it also forces you not to get too fussy, so that is a good thing for me. Because I tend to paint more fussy naturally. I just go there. So this forces me not to get in some more of that ultramarine blue and some of the white. And I'm going to go back in here and just go over this from the corner back over that dark color. I got really squirrely right here. I need to score that off. It's like leaning. So as you paint, check your angles because my angle is getting off right here. This angle is going in, tilting in. Now this angle is tilted in, but this one was more, a little bit more straight up and down, and I've got it tilted way out right now. So I'm just bring this forward right here. Okay, that'll be good. Get some green, add that to my blue. Do the this little bit with a little bit of the teal mixed in with my brown. There. Grab that burnt umber. Put this in with that.
If you're new here, that sound you may have heard is her spraying her palette with fine misted water to keep the paints moist.
Yes. Yes, you're going to want to do that often with acrylics to keep your paints workable while you're painting with them. They dry out real fast, especially this time of year, I find, with the air conditioners running.
Or if you're in the southern hemisphere, your heaters.
Yes.
We just passed the longest day of the year a couple days ago.
Did we?
The 21st, yep. Now the days are getting shorter.
There we go.
In 2020. I'm not sure this year we're going to want to do any hindsight after this.
What do you mean?
Hindsight 2020. This year is pretty bad, so you just might not look back.
Just keep moving.
Just whatever.
Or we're just like, we're glad it's over. All right, going to get some of the unbleached titanium here. Just used whatever's left on my brush here, and I'm going to go along this edge here. There. And it's really dark right in here. I don't know. It got a little thick right there, so I'm just going to go back in with my purple and clean that up right there. Keep it thin right there. Okay. this, maybe a little bit of green. Yeah, this is dryish. Gonna get some of this, maybe a little bit of glazing medium. This is cobalt teal, maybe a little bit of brown. Just doesn't really matter what color it is. Maybe a little bit of this dark from here, and I'm just gonna use it up here on this. I'm noticing that this area here, obviously our light's coming from this direction, so this side's got a little bit more shadow, and this back here has got is darker than this side of the wall back here. So I'm just going to darken this up just a little bit. So if you're following along, going to paint this later, just maybe when you put this on, do this side a little bit darker. I kind of started it that way, and then I added the light color on top. Okay.
I like the style that you're painting in.
Oh, yeah.
I like the fast, quick movements. It just gives it a more random, flowy feel.
Mm-hmm. I do, too. I like this style of painting. It's not the one that I, you know, I really have to think about it to do it, because I tend to not overpaint, but, you know, just like I tend to go for realism.
Yeah, it's difficult to be random. You'd be comfortable with it.
Right. Yeah, it is. It's especially if you're used to painting in kind of more realistic style. So it can be difficult for people to loosen up and paint this way. Okay, so just kind of trying to fade it into this area just a little bit. Get a little bit of that unbleached titanium. Working it back over this area here, and just most of this is going to be covered up, so, but just a little bit of it's peeking through up here at the top, so mostly just get some glazing medium to help me.
You want me to make you a Shirley Temple to help you loosen up?
What? I missed that joke, I guess.
Shirley Temples are non-alcoholic.
Okay. How would that help me loosen up?
I was just being silly.
Oh, okay. Well, I thought I missed the joke. I was like...
Yeah, well, yeah. Obviously, it wasn't a very good joke. Okay.
And obviously, I just made that very clear to everybody.
Yeah, it didn't go the way I had thought in my head.
It's okay, honey. It's only going to be viewed by...
A few thousands of people.
Okay, no pressure. We were just talking about that the other night, you know, about how I was sitting in front of, I don't know how many people are watching right now, but it was like, if they were in the room with me, I would not be able to do this. There's no way. Somehow the safety of my own house with my husband being the only one here, just kind of have that illusion of... anonymity. I can't think of the name.
Anonymity.
Yeah.
Manamana.
Manamana. Yeah. So you know what I'm saying. Or painting. Oh goodness. All right. So there we go. Yeah. I like it. I feel like this angle got weird on me. I'm going to get a ruler here and see. Pretty sure that's not right. Yeah, it's not right at all. So that should be there. How did that happen? I have no idea. Okay. I'm just talking to myself here. Okay, so I'm going to...
You're precise. You're precise.
Measurement is... I nailed it. Skills. I nailed it.
Yeah, it's...
It's close. It's close.
It's close. Close enough for YouTube videos.
Just gonna do like that and pretend like we never had that issue right there. There we go. Now we're straight. Thank God for rulers. It's just darkening that up there and lightening up this side. Ooh, thunder!
Wow.
Kind of mean. Okay. Bring the chair pads in. Yeah. Okay, gonna do one more layer on this foreground here. Burnt sienna, phthalo blue, and some cobalt teal. And just gonna make sure that it looks good. Now that we've got this board here, we did a second coat right there, and just we can go over some of this with a little bit of color. And go right up to the box with it so that it's not got a halo of color around it. If you go over it, we can always fix it. This side again is getting a little bit more light, so we can put the ladder stuff kind of farther up right there. And get some of that darker. Just adding it back here for our second coat on this background color. Again, this kind of goes in right here. And you can help the illusion too if you kind of fuzz out your borders. It makes everything look like it's a little bit out of focus. So we can go back in here and add some of this dark right there. Let me add it right up next to the board here. In fact, I'm going to add some ultramarine blue to my shadow. Come out from it just like that. Got some here, but right in there, in that line there, I can get some of that color and just mix this color and that color together and just blur that edge a little bit. And that will help kind of the illusion of distance there between those two colors. Soften that line. See the difference between that line and that line now? So it's much softer. I'm going to do the same thing here. Just get the color that I've got here and mixing it with the color below and just putting it right along that line and just kind of going right up the middle of those two colors and back and forth. Softening and blurring that line between them. Just a little. Here we go. And same thing with the shadow area there. Don't want it to be harsh, so kind of softening up that edge there. Okay. We're making good progress. Let's go ahead and grab some more ultramarine blue here. I'm going to grab some of this color here and some glazing medium, maybe some white. I'm going to use it on my wood here. And just going to draw some lines down. Going to follow the grain lines, are going to follow the wood lines, this line and this line. So just use those as your guides and leave a little bit of that under color showing through. So I'm just kind of loading my brush up and barely skimming it here so that I'm getting streaks in my wood grain. And get some burnt umber and some of the unbleached titanium and use it I need to see what I'm doing. I'm getting my angle off. My angle needs to be here, so I kind of need to watch that. Keep this angle pushed back straight. Like that. Oops. I think I need to turn it over so I can get into that little corner there. I may won't need to change my brush too. This brush is maybe a little bit too wide. And I need to bring up this side of this a little bit. Split. Bring it down there. Okay. Gonna use the burnt umber black and darken up right here where these two boards meet right here. There's a line down there. And then that line going back right there. And right here, this line on top. Can I have some of the light color? So just get some unbleached titanium here. It's going to be there. We're going to see it right here too. And this brush is too thick for me to be able to get that line there that I need. But I'm going to use it on here before I give it up. So I'm going to get the more of the unbleached titanium and just use it across here. I'm going to go right up against that dark edge that I just did. See? And let it skim across to create my board's texture. Try to keep them even with that outside edge. And I didn't leave the border on that one, so I'm going to have to do that one again. Right here, there's a little where this board is overlapping. All the way down right there. Let's go ahead and use it here. Just get some of the, too much white. You can end it right where this line comes down. So, because we're seeing the ends of these two boards here and here. So this is the middle part here that we're seeing coming this way. And really it's a solid board, so we don't need like separating lines. So try to kind of these three. You can use a bigger brush if you need to. That's this wide, you know, I could have used probably this brush, got a little bit better results, but this one's doing okay. Just there you go. And I need to bring this side up just a little bit. I can see. Okay. Okay, and then we'll see the board here, the board in between the post. It's coming up here too. This brush is entirely too big for what I'm trying to do here. Okay, let me switch to a smaller brush so I don't have too much trouble. So far, so good. And you always want to use the biggest brush that you can comfortably use in a space. Just makes things go faster. So that's why, if you're wondering why I didn't change brushes right away, it's just a little bit easier. Maybe let's use the little squared off one here. The number two bright. What are you doing on your phone?
I was checking the radar.
Oh.
To see. That storm is blowing up right over us.
What?
So that storm is blowing up right over us.
Really?
And then I'm out there grabbing onto the metal umbrella. Yes. Rolling it down, thinking, yeah, this is this isn't the best thing to be doing with that thunder.
Yeah.
But I'm okay.
Good. Good. Our neighbor lost a tree and we lost a Roku in the last
thunder. We lost an Ethernet connection to the Roku.
Yeah. Yeah. We still are able to use it. But not wired. Okay, here we go. So just double check your angles, make sure you're getting this. This is our top edge of our board there. And then this color should be right here too. All the way down. There. And then on the inside of that board a little bit. Again, make sure this angle and this angle match up and that these corners end in the same place. I feel like this blue could come down a little bit more. It looks too blue, we can just add a little bit of burnt umber to it. It's going to make it look a little bit more natural. And this is our shadow side, so it's going to just have some blue tones in it. There, I'm going to just use it to mark the edge of that board there, and then make sure that this matches that angle. And then darken up that back corner there. Put back in that light highlight right here. Okay. And some phthalo blue and my burnt sienna here. Some ultramarine blue. And I'm just going to clean up this back end of this. Bring that color out a little bit. Okay.
Your brush looks like it has ink on it.
It looks like it has ink on it?
Yeah, it's just so that deep blue color, black blue color from here.
Yeah. Okay, there we go. Get some ultramarine blue here. I'm going to actually go ahead and grab this color and just use it in here. So I got mixed up. Let's grab some bleached titanium. It's kind of our base color for this. Most of this, I'm going to use it here. And this little bits of wood here. And up here, I'm going to add more brown. Clear that off. Use the purple to make sure we got a good dark. Square it off section there. Get that burnt umber. Use it right here. Burnt umber, unbleached titanium here. Just need to be a little bit darker than the wood in front. There's like a shadow on it being cast right there. So it's got a dark section at the top. Get some black there to darken that up. There we go. Okay, then using that darker brown white or unbleached titanium mixture there for this square right here. So this will be the edge of it coming up here, and the edges are going to match. This edge and this edge will match, and this edge and this edge will match up.
Unless I built a box. And I notice you're not saying, oh, no, honey, that's not true.
I'm not going to say anything. I'm just gonna keep painting.
Just keep painting, painting, painting. Just keep painting.
No comment. Okay, so going just underneath this raised area right here. See kind of a dark area where this corner comes in. Okay. I'm not going to go much more than that. I don't want to get too fussy. I'm going to get some purple and brown. Put some nail holes in. Oh, they need to be right along this, so I need to put them over enough that it's hitting this little wood piece. All right. I'm just using the corner of my brush with my purple. I put this one too far over, so I'm just going to have to cover it up a little bit. Let's try this. It's easier. Okay, and then I'm going to grab some of the burnt umber and white unbleached titanium. We can use white. We can use white and black if you want it to look more silvery, like a nail. And just go in the middle here and add a little highlight to the middle. I'm just using the corner of my brush. So just dabbing a little color on there. You can make these as weathered as you want to, add more cracks and whatever, but I'm going to keep on moving for now. And grab some green. Mix some of the burnt umber and a little bit of purple with it. Like a dark green. I'm going to use it in here and do some stems that we're seeing through the wood slats. And if you get them over the boards, or you can even tape the boards if you want to make sure you're not doing it. Or we could have done this beforehand. It would have probably been better, but I didn't think of it. So getting some yellow here, just adding some yellow. They're really very like just little hints of color here, so you don't have to be real detailed with this. There's only one that's really more visible than others. It's this one over here. Then we'll do some random leaves in here. Get some of the darker color. Okay, I'm just going to fill this area in with some random dirt. There's actually, I think, some glass jars in here or something, but we're not really seeing what they are. But just need to kind of pick a spot on both of these and just have some leaves coming out from them. So there's one here and one here, and they both have leaves and things coming out. Grab some ultramarine blue, do some leaves with that. And this is literally just kind of filling these blank area here. And then I'm going to, let me see, let me get this brush here. This is a little bit bigger, number four round. You doing okay, hon?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I is.
Good. And I'm going to make some different greens. So some of them a little bit lighter than others. This one's got the cobalt teal in it here. And then make another one that's more of a bright orangey, or not yellowy green, not orange, or yellow green. And then make one that's got more of the blues in it over here. So start laying in some leaf shapes in here. And again, they're all kind of coming in from here. So I'm going to kind of start them there. Start to pick up some lighter colors. And put some of these out. Probably most of this can be covered up, but it'll help us to have some of this underneath when we do our tulips coming out over the crate. And this brush makes leaf shapes real easy because you can just press down to get thicker lines and then just make sure that you're, if you're doing a line, that you kind of commit to it so you don't have transparent sections. You know, you want to have depth in here, and you want to, if it's covering something, that needs to cover it, you know, it doesn't need to be see-through. So figure out what's on top and then make sure that it's covering whatever's underneath. And then make sure that we're not losing all of my dark area either. I'm going to grab some more of this ultramarine blue and add some of the dark lines back in because we've got a lot of the lighter colors coming over top, but we've got some dark in here that we don't want to lose. So let's put one kind of coming right here. So these ones that are folded down, we're just kind of seeing the tops rounded out. And then it's coming down. some more of the yellow. This one here, very white in our picture, so I'm gonna do a little bit more light color there. That did not work out right there. There's going to be a big old flower right here, so it'll cover it up. Otherwise, I would fix it, but I don't know what I was thinking there. Okay, so let's... do some really tall ones so that they'll show up behind our flowers when we go to put those in. And most of this is going to be, like I said, kind of most of this middle area is going to be covered up, but we are going to see into the this bottom half right here is going to be visible. So let's make sure we kind of resolve these areas a little bit and make sure we've got some stems and things that are happening in here that makes look good.
Okay, somebody's got a question. Mm-hmm. They want to know, how do you keep your green from looking fluorescent when you add white to it?
It's because I've added the brown already to it. I added brown down here. Blue. So all these colors, I haven't cleaned out my brush. So all these colors are kind of merging at this point. I've got a pretty much all three of these colors kind of merged into one. But if you were going straight from the phthalo green, color to white, then yeah, you're going to get, kind of a bright fluorescent color. And then you can neutralize it just by adding a little bit of brown or a little bit of the yellow oxide or something like that. So it's a little bit more natural looking. I'm going to do that and add some highlight sections here. So now I've got these leaves and I'm just going to kind of pick a few and highlight them. And they may or may not show up afterwards, but at least we'll know we kind of got them in there looking good. Can I get some blue here? Darken up this area a little bit. So make sure you're kind of crisscrossing these too so that they're merging, looking like they're kind of, you know, competing for space. They're not all kind of staying on one side. Make it look more natural. All right, I think I'm pretty happy with that. And if you wanted to, you could bring some leaves out over the top. I might do that on one of these, even though it's not in the picture. Kind of do like that. Doing it over here a little bit. Let's bring this one down. The tulip leaves kind of widen out a little bit, so they're kind of a blade. It's like a fat blade of grass kind of thing. So Right. And get some. Do some stems for some of these tulips too. We're seeing a few of the necks of them. So do a few of those. Okay. And I'm going to darken up underneath my crate here. Get a little bit of purple and some glaze and just go right up underneath that crate there. It's going to have a little bit of a shadow where it meets the foreground. You can just blend out that front edge a little bit. Make it look like it's not floating. And then if you need to, you can use this color back in here too if it's not dark enough, but I think we got it dark enough. I might just use it to kind of glaze back some of that color a little bit. Maybe on this corner here. Make sure you get your board mostly done before you do this. So you don't want to be editing your crate too much at this point now. For flowers in there. I definitely lost basically all of my depth in the middle of the flower things here. So I'm going to try to recover some of it and just put back some dark areas back in here. We'll see, I might have to fix that later, but let's go ahead and put in some tulips. Get my quinacridone magenta will be our main color for these. White. We'll start with kind of a medium color for our tulips. You see how I'm loading my brush up? I'm going to just kind of keep going that way and kind of have light and dark both on my brush. So that I'm going to get these kind of interesting things happening, and I'm just going to leave them. I'm not going to mess with them. So down, maybe get some of the lighter color on here.
And just like that, a flower shape.
Yeah. Well, this is...
And like you said, your eye will fill in
right
all the empty spots and say, oh, that is a flower.
Right. Right. Yeah. And I with this kind of thing, it's important not to overdo because you can really... Was it? And load your brush really thick with paint so you don't have to press down very hard. You can practice this on paper too. And you may end up getting one that you don't like, and that's okay. You can always go back in, you know, let it dry and go back in and, you know, try to kind of fix it later. But see how I went back in there over it with a little bit of darker color. I'm going to go ahead and get some of this cadmium red on my brush. So I have kind of another color to introduce to some of these. And let's do one that's kind of facing us. So up in here, maybe there's one that's kind of facing us. We're seeing a little triangle of color in the middle. And then petals coming out the sides. Like that. Okay. And trying not to leave too much of that green showing, but it's okay if a little bit of it shows. So let's do another one, big one right here. My color's starting to get kind of blendy, so I need to watch that. Okay, I'm going to do the color behind it up here and do maybe another petal in here, just swooping down into it. And another thick one here. Get some of my bright color for the center of it. And then maybe do another little petal right here. Maybe another one right there. Kind of close it off. Okay. I'm not worried too much about following it exactly what's on the photograph. I'm going to fit as many as I can in here, but I may have to leave a few out. And again, we're doing this very loosely. So I've done tulips more realistically in other tutorials. So if you want to do them more realistically, you can check those out. The most recent one would be the Amsterdam tulips that we did. So you could use that and do those in here instead if you wanted a little bit more realistic looking tulip. These are going to be stylized. So to each his own, whatever you want to do. Not going to hurt my feelings, but I'm just kind of showing you a little bit easier, more loosey-goosey way of doing it. And I probably should have started from the back, working front, because now I'm going to try to have to fit one in here that is right up against this one. So I'm going to do him a little bit darker. And get my light color. Not good. I'm gonna. So the basic shape of the tulip is, you know, kind of a cup. Yeah. So some of these petals are coming out the sides a little bit. The ones that are facing us are more of a circle. This one's got, go ahead and make a bigger petal coming off the side there. Just making sure that I'm getting dark enough areas in the middle. That's the main thing. You don't want these to be flat. So they get flat if you don't have enough depth in the color, that you don't have dark enough darks. So just make sure that you're doing that. You can go back in and darken up certain areas if you need to. All right, so I'm going to keep on going up here and do another one right in here. That was supposed to be right there. And maybe do some petals out that are looking loose. Big one right in the middle, right here. Okay. So at this point, my brush has kind of mixed those colors just by the more, you can see how we started out with very distinct colors. And then by this one, we're kind of, they're all kind of blending together. So we just need to clean my brush off. It's just because it's, you know, it's just a natural thing. The more you use it, the more it's blending your colors as you're using it, you know, even if you're not intending for them to be blended. It's just what's happening. So I'm going to get some more of each of these colors out here, and I'm going to scrape off a clean spot so I can load them easier.
So while she's scraping, Tricibles will be available over on Patreon. .com/AngelaFineArt.
Yes, I usually do the traceables after I finish the painting, so it's, well, they'll be either tonight or tomorrow that they'll be up on my Patreon page. If you want a reference beforehand, I always post the reference. You know, if you need a traceable, if you're painting along and you're, you know, you don't want to wait for the traceable to come out, then we post the reference photo ahead of time, so you could always use that to trace. If you don't want to wait for my response. So
and that's another option. That $2 a month access gives you access to the 3 years worth of traceables.
Yes.
So hundreds.
Yes, there's several hundred now. Several hundred. About We've got 450 videos, and I would say we're doing about 100 to 120 videos a year. So add that up times 3. Maybe that is. Plus the older ones that we had. We didn't have all of my older videos with traceables, but most of them.
So what we're saying is not too bad of a deal.
Right, yeah.
For less than the price of a cup of Starbucks coffee, you can get a whole bunch of art.
Yeah. Or you can get a whole bunch of references that will hopefully help you with your art. Okay, so I'm using this kind of orangey, or not orangey, green-ish color to use in some of these too. Some white here. So this time I'm going to do it right and start from the back and work my way forward. So grabbing a good dollop of white, just pressing that into my brush, pressing down, working it into the fibers of the brush. That's how you should load your brush. Pull a little bit and find a spot on your palette, press down pretty hard and see how that the bristles are opening up to pull that paint into the middle of them. Once you get it loaded, then you can kind of swipe through it to scoop up some on the outer side. And then I'm going to just pull through the magenta on this side of it. So I've got a little bit of both. I'm going to start with, again, kind of a more medium-ish color. And these ones are going to go right up here all the way up to the top. I'm going to get some of that red. Get some of that brighter magenta, press down to the outer part. I'm going to make some movement in this too. I'm going to put one up here. That's maybe out a little bit out of the norm here. Put one down here. Going that way. I'm not loving this one, so I need to do a little bit darker around it, maybe on the bottom here. Define it a little bit better and give it a little bit of petal this way. There we go. That's better. Again, we're kind of getting a lot of mixing going on here. Here we go. This one's looking really weird. Okay, and there's another one down here. Leave it kind of an opened up a little bit.
So just remind everybody that if they need paint, glass palettes, spray bottles, brushes, check out the links to the affiliates down below.
Yes.
Support the channel indirectly.
True. It's a pretty easy way of doing that. Thank you for everybody who's done that. It's great.
And here, it's summertime in the United States, so a lot of anniversaries and things like that. So you can just, you know, tell your significant other, hey, I want this anniversary. Give them the link.
True that. I used to do that with Mark. He used to get me gift certificates to Hobby Lobby and Blick. And
now she just buys herself stuff and says, this is what you got me. Yeah.
Exactly.
So you can try that method too.
I don't. Yeah. I don't wait for him anymore. Learn my lessons. I lifted off the color somehow over there, and I'm not sure what happened. But all right. Come on. Get some of that darker red. Let's do one over here. And get the lighter color. Kind of come back in and do some top petals over in the front. I'm letting this one dry a little bit before, because it was getting kind of goopy. Fun. Okay, so we're going to do a big one right here. So I'm looking at the outside of the flower. I'm not trying to rely on my own memory of what a tulip looks like. If you look at the outside of the reference photo, you can see what's happening with all the different petals. And then get the white, and then look at where I'm seeing the highlights happening. Try to get those in. So do the dark areas first, or the darkish middle to dark areas first, and then going back in with the lighter areas for the highlights. Okay, let's do this one. Just overlapping. So if you have to overlap, just make sure that you've got a dark enough area or light enough, you know, just some sort of contrast, either light or dark, doesn't matter which you choose, just choose one and go. Go with it.
Go in with confidence, no fear.
Yes.
Do not show the flower fear. Show it who's in control.
Right. Yeah.
It's just paint.
It's true. True, yeah. And these are all being done a little bit differently. And I think I'm going to leave this open space right here because I like it. And I might extend this one out a little bit, maybe add another petal. Yeah, okay. You could put one coming down here. Like we could have one that's kind of flopped over here if you wanted to. There's all kinds of different things we could do, so it doesn't have to be exactly the way it is in the photograph. Getting some red here. And go ahead and make a petal coming off here that's kind of it's opening up. Out of white hair. There we go. All right. Let me see if I need to add any more. I feel like I could add one down here, maybe. I'm going to do one that's kind of coming over the edge. I'm going to do a kind of classic tulip shape with it. Let me see if I can get any of this white. So do the upper petals there. Just kind of like that. Okay. Stop there. And now I'm going to grab my smaller round. Get these brushes into the paint or the water so they don't dry out. Get this smaller round brush and some more of my green. Get a little bit of blue if I need to. Go. And just make sure that I've got kind of a good stem on all these ones that are coming up here. Thank you. can use a little bit of the yellow oxide here for some of these stems. And they'll be darker as they kind of attach, so I'm making a mess of this. It's not going to stick. Green. Last little bits here, just trying to make sense of this area. And also giving the flowers a chance to dry so I can maybe put another little bit on them. Grab some of that yellow. Okay. And grab a little bit of purple with that green. So. There we go. I think that's good enough there. It's bright. Clean that brush, not cleaning it out, but kind of wiping off the green there so that I can get a more white here. Mix that in, so I'm getting kind of a brighter green. Then I'm just going to pick a few spots to highlight here and add. And I need some water. Paint's getting very thick. Almost 2 hours. Wanted to do anything over here. Okay, so I think we're... pretty good there. Oh, yeah, and so I definitely want to add just a little bit more detail on my flowers. I'm gonna get the filbert here. Give me a little bit flatter area to work with. So get a little bit of the pink on one side and then the white on the other. So I've got a pretty light color here. Just going to run it through here and add highlights to a few of these petals. See how much this is gonna really make those pop a little bit more. I can use some of the medium value color if I need to blend it in. This one is too narrow there. Petals where I'm seeing light hitting them. And you can see how light these are getting. If they're getting too light, we can always go back in and add a little bit more of the darker color too. So don't have to leave them that bright. But there we go. I don't want to fuss with this too much because it will kind of start to look a little bit muddy if I kind of keep messing with them. So the fine line between, you know, adding the final touches and adding too much, you know. So it's kind of go slowly on this part when you're adding, always when you're adding these last little bits of highlight, because the tendency is to kind of overdo it because it looks good and you're like, oh, that looks great. And then you just keep doing it. And you do it on too many petals, and then it kind of ruins the effect. So just going to go slow and kind of look, stop and look, see, evaluate how it looks after each petal. See if you need to add another little bit. You may not need to. I think I'm just going to leave that one alone because I like that darker bit in the center here. This one needed another petal over the top of this one right here, just to kind of close it off right there. And then I'm going to add some darker around the sides of it to kind of make it match with the rest of the petal flowers. But see that? So what we were kind of doing in that first section is sort of doing the far petals, you know, the ones that are kind of in the back. And then now we're making sure that we've got all our front petals on. And I did most of them already, but a few of them, like that one, just wasn't resolved all the way. So this one, we can kind of define that one as the front petal. Put a few highlights on that guy. That one's pretty fine, I think. And burn that away. How you doing, hon? Being quiet tonight.
I'm just letting you
do my thing.
Paint, yeah.
Thanks. Okay, there you go. By doing it down low here, it opened up that flower in the middle there, so we can put a couple smaller petals back here. I don't know if I like that. I wish I'd left it alone. Let's go ahead and put the dark color back in there. Let's do that again. Okay, I'm going to call that done. Not fun? maybe do a little bit. Mark's laughing at me. I do this every time. Maybe do a little bit more on this wood here. Just add a little bit of the kind of a golden brown tones in it. You probably should do this before you paint the rest of the flowers and things, but it's safe enough. There we go. Maybe add a little bit of this color back here. Just skimmed it a little bit. You could always add a little petals down here if you wanted to add some interest to your foreground. Could make some look like some petals fell down if you wanted to. I'm not going to do that, but you could. All right. What do you think, hon? I feel like I kind of got this off again.
It looks good.
Don't know how I did. Okay, bring this down.
Oh no, because that left side is too low. You gotta push your ruler up more.
Yeah, no, I was... Yeah, okay. It was just up right here.
Yeah,
just
good.
A little bit. I need to bring it down just a little bit. But, all right.
Voila.
There you go. 2 hours later, got a painting.
Not too shabby.
Pretty fun. Hope you try it. If you do, you can share it with me on my social media. I've got all kinds of links down in the description for that. Facebook group is probably the easiest one to use and the one that I'm most likely to see. So I'm going to use a little bit of this blue. I don't have my phthalo blue left, but I'm going to use some ultramarine blue in this cobalt teal and some glaze. I'm just going to glaze some blue on some of these leaves down here in the shadow area. This is totally optional, but I felt like I saw some blues in my picture and I didn't have any in my stem, so just adding a little bit of blue to those leaves there. Not the rail. There we go. Pretty, pretty. On the side. Come up about a quarter inch, because if you sign too low when you frame it, it will cut off your signature. You don't want that. The frame will cover about up to there. All right. Ready to go get some dinner? Do it. Thanks, guys, for watching. We will be back on Saturday with another video for you. What are we painting on Saturday? Oh, we're painting another floral, dark floral this time. This is dark floral number two. If you want to check out dark floral one, you can click on my name or just search for... if you click on my name or my photograph, it'll take you to my homepage on my channel, and you can see, click on the video tab and just scroll down. You'll see all the different videos that we've done over the last 9 years. Also, you can search on YouTube and just put in Angela Anderson Dark Floral, and it'll pop up Dark Floral number one that we did last year or the year before. And so we'll do part two. It's been a while, but I'm really excited to do it. It was a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. And we'll be doing that on Saturday. And then that'll be our last Saturday for a little while. For a couple months, we're going to take Saturdays off this summer.
Yay.
So Mark can work on his garden and
real quick.
Have a weekend off.
What did you use to sign the painting?
That was the Pigma Sakura Fine Brush FB.
Okay. And that and everything else, there's...
Down in the description, there's an Amazon...
Blick.
Blick and Blick.com. Both those links. Blick does not have the list. If you want to see the list of my recommended stuff, it's on Amazon. In the description there. Yeah. So, and give it a thumbs up, like, subscribe if you haven't already, and we will see you on Saturday, hopefully. Thanks for watching. Bye.